Hello everyone. If you want to create your online store, Shopify is a best platform compared to any other online tools, online e-commerce creating platforms. Because in Shopify we can create our store in maximum 30 to 50 minutes. So there is a lot of applications available in Shopify to optimize our store and added extra features in our store. That's one of the great advantage for Shopify users. By using Shopify, the possibility to scale our business to grow. Because Shopify is a self-hosted platform, so we don't need to worry about any security issues or speed issues like that. Because in case of if we are using WordPress, we are storing our files in our own host. But in Shopify, it's a self-hosted. Like this, lot of advantages are available in Shopify to create our store. In this video, we will see about creating our online store by using Express Pantry theme. For example, I decided to create a computer accessories selling shop, selling an online shop. Okay, we can create any kind of store by using this theme. For example, I want to create, and I will show you all the steps to creating a computer accessories selling shop. Okay. First, we need to install the Express Pantry theme in our Shopify store. Just to log in your Shopify account, it will show like this. Okay. It's a dashboard. After you log in, it will show like this. Then just click the online store link. By default, a debit theme already installed in your Shopify store. We just replace our preferred theme. In this video, we will see the Express theme, particularly the bistro style we are using for our online store. Just scroll down, you can see the free themes link. Explore free themes, just click that button. Here, these are all the free themes provided by Shopify. Just choose Express and choose Pantry style. Okay, there is two styles available. We are using Pantry style. Just click the add to theme library. Now the theme is installing in our Shopify store. Okay. It takes some few seconds. Okay, it added. Then we just click the actions drop down menu and hit the publish button. Okay, click publish. Okay, the theme is published in our store. Express theme is activated. Now we are ready to optimize this store. Ready to optimize this theme to our store. Okay, we done the first step, the theme installation. Okay, then the next step, we need to create our store logo. There is multiple options available in online for creating our logo. Logo is an important factor to bring more visitors to your store. It's a brand identity for your store. In Shopify, there is a free tool available to create our own logo. You can use that tool or just use the freelancing sites like Fiverr or freelancing.com or 99designs.com. Like these websites, you can get the very quality logo in few days. If you are a designer, you can use the Photoshop to design your logo. Here I will show you that free tool provided by Shopify, that's called Hatchful.shopify.com. I will show you that. Hatchful.shopify.com. Okay. Yeah. By using this tool, you can create very beautiful logos in few seconds. I will show you how to create our logo. Just click the get started button. Then you choose your business type. I will use this one, health and beauty. It's a just sample purpose, but we are creating a online store for computer accessories, right? But here I am choosing a sample purpose, health and beauty. Then click the next button. Then you choose any icon. Okay. Just give your business name. Your reliable shop. Okay. Slogan is optional. You don't, if you want, you give a slogan, or otherwise just ignore that. Then click the next button. Then choose online store. Then click the next button. Here we can see lot of logos created in few seconds. You can choose your preferred one. Okay. This is one method to create your own logo. Or you can use any other ways I already mentioned. Okay, right now we are created our logo. Actually, I created my logo by using Photoshop. This is a logo I created for the sample purpose, okay, for this demo purpose. Okay, we will use this logo later. I will explain you everything after some time, some steps. Okay, we completed the second step. We created our logo. Then we are moving forward to create our collections. Collections means in Shopify, that's called the product categories. In other places, we are telling like that product categories are here renamed to collection. In Shopify, creating collections is an easy way. Okay, yes. You just hit the products link, the left side menu. There you can see a link called collection. Okay, this is the collections page for our store. I want to create these five different collections, different categories, okay, for my products, because I want to sell the computer accessories in my store, in this demo store. Okay, so I want to create these five collections in our store. I will show you one by one how I am creating these collections in the store. First one is keyboard. Just hit the create collection button. Then you don't worry about any other places. If you want, you can give a small description here. Otherwise, just ignore. That's optional. Okay, so collection image. If you already have a collection image, you can paste there. Right now I will just ignore this. And very important place is the conditions. Okay, because the conditions are using, we are connected the products to a particular category via tags. Okay, and there is lot of conditions we can apply, but I am particularly using product tag, because by using product tag we can easily connect the product to the particular collections. See here, there is lot of conditions we can make. Product title, product type, product vendor, product price. I am choosing product tag only. Okay. just I gave keyboard. Keyboard is a tag. Okay, then click the save button. Okay, we created a keyboard collection. Then we are moving to the next, another collection, creating another collection. Okay, so the next one is mouse. Now the tag mouse. Okay. Okay. Just click the save button. The next one is headphone. Create another collection. And after that, I will create a new collection. Pen drive. Okay, you can there. Save button. The final one is external hard drive. Okay. We created all five collections. We will see later how we are connecting these collections to display products in our store. We will see later after some doing some optimization, doing some steps. After that, we will see how we are connecting these collections in the store. Okay, so we created collections. Okay, the next step is installing applications. Applications are very useful to optimize your store, and those applications are make your store the next level. We can add some core features in the store by adding the applications. So applications are very useful in Shopify. Compared to other online platforms, Shopify applications are very powerful and easy to use. Let me see how we are installing applications in Shopify. Here in the left side menu items, you just see there the apps link. Okay, you just click that. Okay, so then after that, click there, visit the Shopify app store. Ladies and gentlemen, we can install multiple applications, whatever you want in the app store to your Shopify store. But here I am showing the only two applications, very important, and because this is a demo store, just you see how to install the applications and how to use. And after that, depending upon your future requirement, you can choose any applications for your Shopify store. The first one I prefer to use is a contact form. Okay? Because in the contact form, we can simply give our email address, but better we are giving a form that's a very attractive for the visitors. That's why I suggest you to use a Shopify application in the contact form. Simple contact form. Okay, let me use this app, contact us form with CAPTCHA, okay, by healthcaps.com. This is a free plan available. If you use, because there's a lot of applications available, but I prefer now this application. If you prefer to use any paid app, but before that you just try their trial period, because on the trial period you can practice that app for better experience. After that, if you satisfy only, you purchase the premium package. Just click the install app button. Okay, the application is installed. Then here you can choose the settings, customizations. Actually here we don't need this contact us heading, because already we have a heading in the page heading also. So just we remove the contact us heading here. Just we are start with fill out the form and we will get back to you as soon as possible. Okay. Just we remove that contact us title. How we can do that? Just scroll here. Okay, I think in the first step that's available, I think. Just you remove that, just delete that, then okay, everything perfect. Just click that, then hit the finish button. Okay, this is our form code. Okay, you just copy this form code. Okay, and I paste it in your notepad file. Okay. We will use this code in the contact page later. Okay, I will inform you that after some steps. Okay, then the next application is called Eperlo. Eperlo. Okay. Eperlo drop shipping and branding. This application is a very free and very best compared to any other applications available in Shopify. Most of the products are from China. If you prefer to drop shipping products from China, this app is very very best one. But if you prefer any US based drop shipping company, Shoppocket is a best one. Okay, so here in this store, I will use this one. Just click here, then just add app. It takes few seconds to install in your Shopify store. Then just install app. Okay, to install the application, okay, right now these two applications are enough to create your dropshipping store. If you want to more features, you can add applications from the app store. Okay, we completed the installing apps section. Then we are going to create the imported pages. Okay. The important pages means every shop will need some pages are very important. For example, the terms of service, privacy policy, refund policy, about us, contact us page. These pages are very important. You can see all in all stores, these pages are perfectly they are created. Because these pages are very helpful to the customers to read all the information about the store owner and their services and everything. They can easily get all details from these pages. So we need to create these pages and integrate in our online store. That's a very important work. Then okay, let me see how to create those pages. Just click the online store. Pick the pages link. Okay, then click the add page link. Okay, the simple way to create these pages, we can use some already pre-built tool available in Shopify. I will show you. Just click the settings link here. Here you can see the section called legal. Okay, here you see the first one is a refund policy, create from template. Okay, just you copy and paste this content to your page. The first one is refund policy. The second one, create another page. It's a privacy policy page. Okay, we just hit the create from template button. Just Ctrl A, Ctrl C. Copy the content and paste the content. Privacy policy. Just click the save button. And after that, we are going to create the terms of service page. Just click the create from template. Just copy the content. Create another page. Okay, just click the save button. Okay, then next page. Okay, the next one is shipping policy. That's an optional page. Okay, so after that, we need to create the about us page. Before creating this page, you create your own content for using this page. Okay, about us. Here I just putting a sample text. You can use your own words in this page. Welcome to our online store. Okay, just I'm using a sample text in this page. then click the save button. The next one, create another page, is called contact us page. These 5 pages are very important in each store. Contact us page, okay. So just, you remember already we created a small script by using the contact page application in last step. Just copy and paste that script in this page, okay. I already copied that script in the notepad. You can see that, okay, the embed code, okay. You just copy the code and paste it here in the HTML view. Control V. Here you can do one thing. If you know a small bit of HTML knowledge, you can centralize this form by adding this simple comment. Div tag, okay. Div align equal to center. Okay, close the. Then close the div tag. This is optional, this is not a mandatory, so this is optional. If you want to show the contact form in the center of the page, you can use this command. Okay, then after that you just click the save button. Okay, now we are created 5 important pages for our Shopify store. Okay, for these 5 pages. Adding products, we are using that already we have installed the Aprilo application. We are using that application to add products in our store. Just click the ads. Just click the thing. Okay. First one, find product. Okay. First is keyboard, right? Each category I will add 4 or 5 products. Keyboard, okay. Keyboards. Okay. Just the end. Then the second one. Okay. This one and this one. Okay, we are adding four products. Okay. So those all products are comes to this import list. We just need to assign the tag and push to store. Okay, I just copy. Okay, the first one select and push to store. Then second one, just control V, push to store. And third one, then fourth one, okay, this one, okay, push to store. Okay, we added 4 products in keyboard category. Then after that we next find products. This time we are finding products for mouse. Okay. Yes, there is the sound. This one selected. This one. Then this one. Okay. Next. Testing the next page. Okay. Selected this one. Okay. These 4 products. Just check the import list. Here, use the tag push to store. Here, the tag mouse push to store. Okay, here you can do one thing, you can optimize the titles also. Just you can update the titles also here, just before you pushing that particular product to the store. Then tag one. Selected and assign mouse. Mouse is a keyword, so assign the tag to the particular product and push to store. Then final. Okay, the next one. Keyboard, mouse, then headphone. Okay, so we are searching the product. Okay, so headphone, wireless headphone. Okay, I just selected 4 products. Those all products are comes to import list. From there, just select the particular product and assign the tag. And push to store. This is a repeated work. But you need to properly, because the titles are very important and you can optimize before that pushing the particular product to the store. Yes, select headphone. Okay. Then again we search the product for pen drive. Okay, yeah, very good. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So these products are considered the import list. Just select that particular product, pen drive, push to store. And the next one, next one. Okay, let's do store. Let's do next one. Let's do store. Okay. Okay, then again we find product for external address. Okay, external hard drive, just add products to the well import list. Okay, just check import list, select a particular product. Okay, then we have external. External hard drive. Okay. Hard drive is a key. It's a tag. Then send that and push to store. The next one. Hard drive. Tag. Then the next one. Okay. Right now we added each four products to the each categories. Okay. So almost 20 products we are added for these categories. Okay, we completed this step also. Then the next one is a stock photos. Why we have stock photos? Because we are using these stock photos in the banners. That's the sliders. It will give them more attractive and our customers can easily understand what type of services we are offering to our customers. That's why we are using stock photos. Stock photos, by using free stock photos, we don't need to purchase any licenses. So I want to suggest one website. That's a Pixels. Okay. Here you can get thousands of free stock photos are available. So you can use it for your online stores. But particularly in this theme, we don't need any more requirement for the banners or sliders, because all parts are pointing to the products only. So we don't worry about the slider photos. So that's why I just selected only one photo. I already stored that photo in my folder. Okay. This photo only I take from that particular site, pixels.com. Okay, once you captured your stock photos, then you are ready to update the theme settings and the page optimization, front page optimization. Before optimize our home page and other pages, design works, we need to complete all the basic steps and essential requirements before we starting to optimize our home page. That's why we installed the theme and created a logo, and after that we created the collections, and after that we created all the required pages, important pages. Then after that we have added all the products for the categories. Then we collected the stock photos also. Then now we are ready to optimize this theme settings and optimize our store front page and other pages. Okay, so for optimizing your theme settings, you just click the online store. Okay. First, we need to create the menu settings. Okay. Before that, I show you here. You see, this is a default view. Now we are optimizing this page with our already updated content. Okay. Okay. So the first one, we create the menu. Just click the navigation. It's the main menu. Main menu is located in the top of the website. You just click that. Here the main menu will come. Okay. Just to delete the existing items. Just leave that home page link. Okay. Then after that, just click a menu item and collections. The first one, keyboard. Okay. Just add. Second one, mouse. Just choose collections and mouse. Okay, just tag. Third one, collections, keyboard, mouse, pen drive. Okay, and fourth one, just keep collections, headphone. Okay, the cyan collection is external hard drive. Okay, we just added all the collections in the menu item. It's a top menu. Okay, then after that, added this item, just click save. If you want to show any drop down menu items, just you drag this particular product, particular menu category in inside, so it will be go the submenu of the upper menu item. Okay, so in the store we are not using any submenu items, that's why I'm just leaving that. Okay, here now the keyboard and mouse. The mouse is a subcategory of keyboard, so we don't need like that. Just we place all the items in the main menu. Okay, just we can drag the positions, priorities. Okay, then after just click the save. Okay, we created the top menu item. Then after that, now we are ready to create the another one menu item that's called footer. Footer menu. Okay. Here we just remove the search option. Okay. All the required pages we will show in the footer page, footer section. Okay. So I just add all the important pages in footer section. The first one is about us. The second one is which is terms of service. Then privacy policy. Then refund policy. Finally, we will add the contact page, contact us page. Okay. Okay. Then you just click the save button. We created two menu items, one for top menu and another one for footer item. Okay. We will configure these menus in the theme settings. Okay, let me go for the updated theme settings. Okay, just you click the customize link. After creating menu items only, it's not show in the store. Okay, we need to configure the menu items and other settings in the theme settings section. Then only we can see the updates in the the inside design view. Okay. Okay. The header part. First, we are ready to add our logo. We already have created our logo. I just upload it. Select that and adjust the logo with the maximum size. Okay. Then choose a menu. Main menu. Okay. Then select. Okay. Then. Okay. That's all. Then click the save button. Let me check it's updated or not. Okay. Yeah. It's updated. It's a logo and the menu sections. Here's the top top bar. Here we can put any informative text to our customers. It's just like that our discounts, our offers, or any text we can display in this space. What we will do, just I will show you some announcement about the pre shipping. Okay. Place order more than $75 and get free shipping worldwide. Okay, so then just click the save button. Okay, we completed the header part. Then we move to optimize the next one. It's the main. Okay, here we will see. Okay. Okay, this is the main important top slider section. So we just add our collected image from pixels. Okay. Okay, here you can give you some text, informative text. Best quality products or best quality. Okay, then you give your introduction text here. The save button. Okay, let me see in live. Okay, this is like this. Okay, this is something like this. Okay. Then after that, these are the featured sections. We will do that. Just okay. Okay, then. These are the collections. Just select a collection. We'll choose all collections here one by one. First one keyboard, then second mouse, then this external part, just for enough, I think. okay. Let's click the save button. Okay. Okay, we completed the featured collections. Then here is the image with text. Okay, you select any image here. I just choosing the existing image because it's a demo purpose only, but you choose different image related to your store product. So here I'm giving title best price, second one is best price. Okay, here the button label view more. Okay, so just hit the save button. Then the next one matches the same image. Best offers, the next one. View, so view more. Just click the save button. Okay. Then after that, here the same thing. Okay. See, this is our creator store logo, menu items. It's the main banner image and the some titles and some descriptions here. These are the featured collections section. Okay, and after that, the next part, we can use multiple images to define our multiple product categories. Okay, from here, and after that, again the featured sections are here. They are giving, but we have created only 5 categories only. So I want to hide this particular. Hide this section, okay. I want to just hide this section. Okay. Then featured product. If you want to promote any particular single product, just use this option. Okay. Just select the product. Okay. I use this one. Actually, by using this section, you need to optimize the particular store product page, not lengthy, just very simple. Then only it will be attractively shown in the home page. See, I added this particular product. See how it works in the live mode. See here. Okay, so these are the main two sections after the featured product section. See here, it will go long because there's a lot of multiple images are added in that particular product. So before, if you want to promote your featured product in this section, you just optimize and enable only one single product under particular product, and you reduce and optimize the that product title and descriptions also very, very less. So I just hide this section. Okay, I hope you understand the process. So because for the design view, I just hide because I'm not going to optimize the product title and other descriptions, and again I added here. That makes some more time, so I just hide this section. I hope you understand this process, I think. Okay. So then after that, we are going to optimize the footer section. The first one, talk about your business. Okay, just you give them welcome to our store. You just give some small introduction here. Okay, that's why they are giving this feature here. Then after that, this month discount code. Okay, discount code of the month. Okay. Here you can display some discount code for particular category, so your store owners can easily find the discount code and they are using that discount code for the purchase. Okay. The next one is better, and I want to add the menu, footer menu. Okay, quick links. Okay, I just want to show here. Okay. And also I want to show the payment options also. Okay, show the language selector also. Just click the save button. Okay, let me see the updates in the live mode. Okay, so here this is the top of the section, the announcement bar and logo and menu items, and this is the first important slideshow section, but here there is no any slideshow. There is the title section here. Okay, banner section here. Then after that, the featured section. Okay, the featured section. After that, the two important sections here, then the footer link. Okay, just let me check the inner pages. Okay, this is the keyboard. Okay, these are the product for each section. If some products inventories are zero, that particular products are not shown in our collections. Okay, if anyone have some doubt, because we added 4 products in each category, right? But here showing only 2 products only, because that particular product quantity is zero in stock, that particular product not visible in our store. Okay, then about as the text content, terms of service, see the terms of service. Okay, okay, that's all guys. If you have any questions or any doubts about these steps we already created in the store, just you play that's just you ask in the comment section, I will reply. And if anything I could, I will create one another one new video with detail for your questions. Okay, I hope this video is helpful to you. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. We will see you on next video with another theme, and I will show you how to create your online store on that particular theme. Thank you very much. Bye.